In Sufism, it is really about being receptive. It is about listening. It's about creating an empty space. In that way, it's a little bit closer to certain forms of Zen meditation. You just create an empty space. And its nearest equivalent in the West is probably, as far as I've come across, the meditation practiced by St. Teresa of Avila, which was called at the time the meditation of the quiet, which has to do with divine receptivity. You create a space of being receptive to God, of waiting for God. She had to be very careful about who she said this to, because the church at the time were concerned that you actually just did prayers, verbal prayers all the time. They didn't like the idea that you might actually experience God. But this was the meditation or prayer of the quiet, which has to do with divine receptivity. And as Sufism is about learning to make a relationship with God, you learn to be receptive, you learn to wait, you learn to be attentive, and you learn to listen. You learn to listen to a very different vibration or a very different language that has to do with the vibration of the soul. It has to do, I say it's feminine. The soul is always feminine before God. It's one of the mystical secrets that a patriarchal culture kind of pushed to one side. But it is about a state of divine receptivity. Rumi, of course, put this very beautifully. He said, make everything in you an ear, each atom of your being, and you will hear at every moment what the source is whispering to you, just to you and for you, without any need for my words or anybody else's. You are, we all are, the beloved of the beloved. And in every moment, in every event of your life, the beloved is whispering to you exactly what you need to hear and know. Who can ever explain this miracle? It simply is. Listen, and you will discover it every passing moment. Listen, and your whole life will become a conversation in thought and act between you and him, directly, wordlessly, now and always.